welcome to the Moray Cup 2016 lower bracket playoff between Bell Gaming and Fettyattack786. This is a best of three. The winner goes forward
remaining
to play against Ellen All-Stars, and the loser is out of the tournament. I think, Death Prophet ban out by Fettyattack786, and Zeus will be banned as well. Can we see
Radiant them both getting through here?
Voker OD, fingers crossed. See whether or not Bell Gaming.
10 seconds remaining.
With that Zeus ban, obviously. They're gonna ban the Spectre at least. Both the OD and the Invoker. Bell Gaming have to choose one, and I think Fettyattack have the first pick, so they will pick up the Invoker for
Radiant team pick.
That will definitely happen. Yes.
Dire team pick.
No, Spectre happily banned out this time. Maybe they can give Lambda something that he won't suck so hard hard with. I was down the docks last night and bumped into a couple of ladies, and for a
dire
bottle of Buckfast
and
packet of fags between them, they were willing to do all kinds of things. So they were asking me, oh, you know, what do you do? And I was like, oh, I'm a commentator. And they're like, oh, what are you commentating? And I says, oh, I'm commentating the Moray Cup. And they're like, oh. One of them's like, oh, my son plays, he's in that tournament. And the other one was like, oh, my brother's in that tournament. And I was like, oh, what? And they're like, oh, yeah, we're
Radiant
Moray. And I was
team
like, oh,
pick.
Who is this guy? And like, oh, it's Lambda. So, yeah, man, some of that salt on your sister's lips there. You can thank me for that. Right, so Puck and Disruptor picked up for Bell Gaming. Puck, quite a strong mid. The ability to be the blink, the mobility, very high.
10 seconds
and obviously
remaining.
Phase Shift gets you out of a lot of trouble. And the Dream Coil, obviously.
5 seconds remaining.
$4 million Dream Coil. Such a great ability. Silence, stun.
Radiant team back.
Timbersaw picked up for the offlane. I wonder if that will be for Antonio Lamau. I think he will be on the Timbersaw.
Ten seconds remaining.
With the way the first match went, I would have thought that Fettyattack
5 seconds remaining
might ease off a little here in regards to their hero choices.
Reserve time.
Invoker, such a strong pickup, and Timbersaw, huge. I mean, anything that Bell Gaming are going to put in the safe lane doesn't really want to be a strength carry. Silencer then, the Fun Stopper, banned out by Fettyattack 786. A response from Bell Gaming for their third ban. I mean, what did they look at? Ban supports, I guess. Ban a safe lane carry. Where we can see Sven.
10 seconds
Sven
remaining.
Sven pick up for make Bloodseeker great. Maybe a Bloodseeker.
5 seconds
so
remaining.
We don't get. We don't
Radiant
get
team ban.
I think we saw it once, and I don't think it went that well. Bloodseeker plus Zeus, or Bloodseeker plus Invoker is really strong though, because you've got that global vision, and you can also amp his damage with the Blood Rage.
Dire team ban.
So, Bounty Hunter and Slark both banned out. Slark, strong agility carry. I mean, I think we could be seen as Sven here, maybe. Or...
10 seconds remaining.
The Silence, the Spectre, I mean, it could be an Anti-Mage.
5 seconds remaining.
Could be an Anti-Mage pickup for...
Reserve time.
Fettyattack 786. A Medusa pick from
dire
Bell
team
Gaming
pick.
Scooters, but there is an Enchantress ban out now, and they've picked up the Shadow
Radiant
Shaman, so
team
only
pick.
Their core is left to go. That will narrow the bans for Fettyattack 786 down. Two nice supports though, D-Push-Push with Shadow Shaman, you've got the Hex, the Shackles for the Lockdown, you've got Disruptor with Glimpse, Static Storm, the Kinetic Field, and this bloody huge, oh no, what's this one called? Thunderstrike.
Dire
well.
Team pick.
with the dream coil. I mean, it's really nice. Tusk pickup then for Fettyattack 786. That is going to be a support tusk, I think. We'll see him in the safe lane support role, which means we could be seeing a ranged support, a ranged carry even, so maybe the Medusa for Fettyattack 786.
10 seconds remaining.
Tidehunter for the offlane. Radiant for team pick. Dummy. It's a nice pickup. It works. It synergizes well with what they've already got. Fourth pickup for Fettyattack 786. I mean, this is going to be a support for sure. Witch Doctor. Dazzle.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Bench even would be okay, I guess.
Anti-mage.
Oh no, they're going to go straight in and pick up dire the anti-mage, as expected. Like I say, with the tusk, the anti-mage with the mobility, what they've banned out really hamper, I mean, the global presence from the Spectre, able to jump on you anywhere. Slark with the Shadowblade.
10 seconds remaining.
The Silence from Silencer able to set all that up.
5 seconds remaining.
Death Prophet, not so much of an issue though, actually. Legion Commander, quite a good pickup for Bell Gaming here.
Radiant team ban.
The Lion, I mean, Phantom Lancer, not that great. I mean, it's okay. Sven still looks pretty good, actually, for Bell Gaming.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
So, Sven banned out by Fettyattack. I mean, that was last good carry I think that they could get in there. Maybe a Doom or a Nightbringer. A Nightstalker even. Might be fast enough. Lycan. Legion Commander. Yeah, I think the Legion Commander is pretty good here.
10 seconds remaining.
You've got plenty of range for it. Oh, the PA.
Radiant team pick.
I'm not so sure about this. Invoker has got a lot of magic damage. Timbersaw, pure damage in your lane already. Tusk, Snowball, Shards, Anti-Mage. I'm going to build an MKB for sure. He's going to have the farm for it anyway, so.
Final pickup.
I mean, it's going to be a support. It's going to be Witch Doctor, or Dazzle, or Bench, or something of that ilk.
Reserve time.
Maledict could be great for shutting down PA. Silence would be what you'd want, though. Support Bloodseeker, Jungle Bloodseeker, done level 6, gets Rupture, gets Blade Mail, makes space for Anti-Mage to farm. But no, we'll see. I mean, it's got to be Witch Doctor, right? Or Dazzle. Nope, they're going to go aggressive and pick up the Venge. And let's see how the lanes will unfold. Kingy will definitely be on the Invoker. It's a specialty hero of his. Antonio Lamau on the Timbersaw as expected. Make Bloodseeker great will be on the Tusk. Alex will pick up the Anti-Mage. And that leaves... I wish they wouldn't change their names. Anyway, Planeshron will go mid with the pack. Lambda on the Disruptor. Stevie on the Phantom Assassin, Big Daddy, Blobs FS Crazy, gonna go off lane in with the Tidehunter and the Banter King. Princess Diana will pick up the Shadow Shaman. So, let me have a quick look at the items here, see what we've got going on. Who smokes this time from either team? We do have a sentry from Make Bloodseeker Great on the task, and sentry and an observer on Lambda. Lambda on the Disruptor. I wonder if they just couldn't trust him with farming after his piss poor performance in the last game, which cost them the match. Oh, a little bit of salt from the salty bitch.
30 seconds to battle.
Interesting to see whether or not he can fuck up support Disruptor as much as he fucked up Kari Spectre. Okay, so
the battle
bottom room
begins.
Goes to Kingy, I think.
Tis mine.
He does manage to jump in and snatch the rune from Antonio Lamal. He went with reactive armor, so he will get some of his hit points back after that one attack. And we got a beautiful ward here in the. Beautiful ward here in the Radiant, from the Radiant in the Dire pool camp, small camp. We got a ward as well. Oh, can't draw on this map. Got a ward as well here. It's a nice ward for the Dire. I would like to see something around about here maybe, or here. Just give the vision there. Antonio Lamau then, last hits. Stevie having a bad time, it seems, getting his last hits. The supports here not doing enough to, I mean, I don't know if I should be getting pummeled by the right clicks. There's a Shackle, so it's a bit early, but we could see a kill here on Antonio Lamau. He did level up reactive armor though, so he will be healing. And Stevie, looking for the kill, there's the first blood. Gonna be quite happy with that. Image top of the bus, last hits Alex, side pulling to the jungle camp here as well, really trying to deny
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Blobs FSS crazy at all. Kind of going in here a little bit. There is going to be a snowball which will have shards to follow up, but no follow up from the army mage. A little bit disappointing. Wave of Terror. Snowball, just to change aggro there. It's a little bit of side farming going on by the support.
It shall not be.
Attack 76. Alex having no real problems here with Big Daddy Blobs FS Crazy. Nice ward here, actually. Ping, yeah, I mean,
got
a little
it.
Bit early. It does see anyone sitting up behind if Puck pushes forward. Oh, gonna catch him with the orb. It seems like it's still level 1. Oh, actually, that was a level 2. He did nothing. Disruptor misses the pool. Doesn't stack the camp. Let's fail. Gonna put in a right click on Antonio Lamau. He does have tangos to trade and he's carrying a smoke.
You're not going
there
anywhere.
Goes the chains and they're gonna jump in again with the static thunderstorm. The chain away. Is there gonna be a glimpse? No need. The shaman will find him with the ether shock. Make Bloodseeker great though. Immediately TPs into the lane. He's gonna soak up some XP in the meantime. They're gonna try going on him. Here's the dagger. And the thunderstrike. I expect he should snowball here. No, just gonna back it off. Had enough of that. He's got a couple of sentry wards. King to D ward maybe. Oh, there's an invis rune mid here. He's gonna spot that out. This King, I don't think Kingy needs it. I think there's a good opportunity for a gank here.
Invisibility!
Playing Sean realizes something's up immediately. There is a cold snap.
Gift from the goddess.
Can't sling it off. Oh, that's sweet, man. Great mid against Invoker indeed. UFC looking for the stun though. Still level 3, so no swap. Make Bloodseeker great, trying desperately to use this invisibility before it is used up. He's in position. There's a snowball, immediately followed up by the glimpse. There's an EMP, Nuke's mana, Kingy with the tornado. He's taking so much damage from the tower and there's no one for him to right click on. He just makes it away, he pops a fairy fire and so close, very dangerous play. Didn't secure the kill either. Quite a huge investment from Fettyattack786. Stevie managing to find about equal farm to the Ani Mage despite the issues with the top lane there. The two kills as well, going to be doing a great amount for the net worth. Yep, sitting top of the bus there, farming as a right click farmer should farm. Playing a Sean as well, managing to keep fairly even with the Invoker mid. Invoker's roaming now, so he is actually falling behind a little bit, just to catch up. Kingy's returned now. Playing strong, bottles up. Phase shift out. There's two creeps for him to pick up here. Yep, he gets the first one.
Denied!
Second one's denied by... We are going to see a pull attempt by... Lambda, that should be successful. 8 miles.
Illusion.
Creep count, creep wave so far forward though. What we needed to see was the pull into the creep wave here. And I think they could have drawn in the timber saw and messed them up. So Anti-Mage able to farm these camps as well. He has got his Perseverance at 6 minutes and he should have his Battlefield by about 12-13 minutes if his farm continues like this uncontested. The shackles again, this time on Tusk. Tusk gonna go down and Antonio Lamau in some serious issues as well. Will we see the glimpse back? No need. Puck blinks in and secures the kill. Good trade. 2 for 0. 666 gold going the way of the Dire. 645 XP. Just rotating at the right time.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Kingy looking to try and do some damage. You're going to have to be careful.
Greetings!
Lunatron blink again. Gets caught out by the tornado though. And the EMP might catch him as well. A little bit of damage. Not much mana left. There's the cold snap. The phase shift out. He manages to juke through the
Dire's
trees and escape. Nicely
attack.
Done. King 8, we can continue to push the tower here.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Meanwhile, Antonio Lamau
in
a little bit of trouble again.
They
spotted him out. He's so close to getting in his ring. I presume he's building a vanguard or something.
Dire's bottom
Here's the
tower
chains.
Is under attack.
He's taking a lot of damage. Phantom Assassin, Stevie picking up the last hit there. Putting him back ahead as far as net worth is concerned.
Dire's bottom
just,
tower
you know,
is under attack.
Just, showing Lambda how to actually carry. And the difference it makes as well, the pressure that it exerts when your enemy is aware that your carry is carrying hard. The problem problem with this lineup though for Bell Gaming is they need to win by about 25 minutes. Because they don't have the late game. But Lambda picks up a kill there on the Vengeful Spirit. And yeah, quite funny. A Ravage for position 5. But at the moment, 6 up. Quite a good position to be in. Can't really complain. 9 minutes in. Banner King looking for the pull. It's a bit early. The lane creeps are too far forward. If he goes that way, he is going to have to body block a little bit. But I mean, he's so close to being able to get it there. And he could have just headed up and pulled the lane in.
I'm out.
Kingy looking for some action mid here. Lambda's there. Gonna get caught out with the tornado. No EMP to follow up. Meanwhile, Anti-Mage gonna push bottom. We're gonna see a TP in from Tidehunter. He doesn't have his ult up. It's on cooldown for a minute and a half, but Anti-Mage gonna back off. I mean, this is a perfect opportunity to try and take down the Tidehunter when he's vulnerable.
Time for a tag team.
Tusk with the illusions, gonna scout out the jungle with him. Oh, helping Kingy out here. Looking for a target. There's nothing there for him to find unless he wraps all the way around. They're gonna spot out Shadow Shaman on PA here now with this illusion. Gonna go on it. We're probably gonna see a rotation. We see a rotation in from Lambda as well. And PA keeping an eye on it, but obviously Tusk coming in from the bottom and Kingy coming in from the right hand flank there. There's going to be a tornado onto the Shadow Shaman. The party ring goes down, but it's in a bad place. EMP goes down and followed up by the shards and Shadow Shaman out of action. But the counterattack is here now, Pat with the Dream Coil onto Invoker and Tusk with casualties in the exchange. Oh, the blink back onto Venge. Venge manages to get outside the party ring and then decides to run around and try and get the deny on the creep. Unfortunately, the Disruptor's Thunderstrike manages to get the final blow.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Wow, Lambda's almost in the same position for farm as he was in for the whole last game. On Disruptor support. Anti-Mage picks up Battle Fury, 11 minutes 24 seconds, that is a beautiful timing. No pressure at all on Alex down here in the safe lane. The Tide just a non-entity really, unfortunately Blobs FS Crazy not able to do anything without rotations from some ranged people or some people with some more stuns. Like he needs the Shadow Shaman to lock him down or someone with an Orchid, maybe the Puck picks up an Orchid. Timbersaw going to try and stack. He manages to pull it off successfully. It's a really difficult stack that one. To pull that way. The box is like right here, so you have to get them clear out. It's really difficult. Well played. Lambda and Blainatron sitting mid, waiting for some action. MFC. Moving in, gives him a black high ground. He's going to try for a little bit more with the Wave of Terror. Looking for Lambda, looking for a rotation to top. Disruptor going to get caught out here.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
And the cold snap, there is the ball. The snowball, the shards. He only manages to get down the kinetic field. Doesn't monster, he's only level 5 at 13 minutes, the similar story to last time. Out that level 6 ult, how is he even going there? Just really bad game sense.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
On XP at the Radiant team. So MFC with the howl onto Stevie.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Alex just farming away. Evie managing to maintain with the kills. Managing to maintain equal farm on Image for now. But
I assume he picks up off Lance next, and then shit goes down. Oh, our rotation. Blanatron is here in the jungle. Bob's FFT coming in behind them. There's Silence on the Ravage. And Atomiro's here though with the Whirling Chain.
Get me to the Undersea.
The Whirling Death against the pure damage. Throwing them since here. So Anti-Mage does end up going down the disruptor. And one kill is going his way, denying the fatigue.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower has fallen.
Doing okay out of it.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
The Banner King looking to try and this tower. Maybe some wards. Besides Steel, Roping Chain, Eevee's TP too slow. They're not going to put an eye on the tower either.
Dire's bottom tower.
They're going to try
and
get a kill though on McBusky again. Tusk a lot of them. There should be a snowball to protect them. Not going to have ult is up though from the disruptor. But at this point, it's just a little bit too weak to get anything done. Or for Blanatron, he could catch them here. Not have the Anti-Mage is right behind him though. With the silence, he finds the Anti-Mage. A little bit of a gash from Big Daddy onto Anti-Mage. And they're just gonna call it quits there. They took the tower. They didn't do any damage to the tier 2. The one will be the next target of Obby, I've no doubt. Wanna get some farm up though. I think Anti-Mage wants to get his Vlads finished. And see if he picks up the Morbid Mind there.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Unless you do that, I guess.
Radiant structures are fortified. Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Once again, Anti-Mage with the Invoker.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
So, quick pause then. Run through the items that have been picked up. So, Kingy has his. This is 16 minutes of phase boots. Drums and endurance, Urn of Shadows and the casual Null Talisman. Anti-Mage though, struggling a little bit here. He does have really good farm, but he's must be sitting on some gold. But he has Power Treads, Battle Fury and Stout finished up 16 minutes. He finished the battle for about 11 and a half minutes, so there's been no item for him. He must be sitting on gold. I think he did die as well. Meet Bloodseeker Great, looks like he will build into the Guardian Greaves. I already have Arcane Boots and a headdress there, so Mech should be on. Arcane Boots and Soul Ring for Antonio Lamal. Just ensuring that he's got the mana sustain. Battle Fury actually finished up for the Yeda. How's the Ring of Aquila? He's slightly better with her farm, seems, than the Anti-Mage, but Anti-Mage is 1,300, so presumably his next item should be. I mean, I feel like he's going to be on Lance, but maybe he picks up like a Bash Arst or MKB, or MKB so slow would be a little bit dangerous.
Well gotten gains.
Going to be another pause here. We'll run through the names of Bell Gaming. Big Daddy, Bob's FS Grizzy, he's got the Arcane Boots and the headdress as well. That will probably go into Mech, I would think. Just an Null Talisman on the ball on Blink. Obviously, I think he must be saving for Blink. Our boots on Banner King. Stevie, the Battle Fury, like I said, and the Aquila, and the Poor Man's Shields, as well as Treads. Starts in a really good position as far as farm is concerned. Arcane Boots and a completed wand for Disruptor. That's not too shabby, actually, for that. Seems like he's playing position 4. So, just a little pause here while we have some loss issues for the players. looking at the war position and on the map at the moment, let's have a look at camps. Nothing stacked. We do have, I think, no stacks anywhere. That's unfortunate. Four supports, you think someone would have got to do it. No normal Dominator helm holder. Matthews decides to do that and go satanic, but he can't use that type of lifesteal with his mark steel, so I'm
on. Under the weather!
My goddess wished you dead!
So, Lambda just so badly out of position there, picked by Invoker and the Animage and the Venge. Three say that move on to him while he's none the wiser. It does look like it will be a Yasha. I don't know whether or not he'll finish up the Manta style for the others, but he definitely is going to pick up a Yasha first. It'll give him more chase potential and it will speed up his fight. Tide trying to solo away these agents. Should be no issue at all. Levels of dragon shield are nice. Oh, make Bloodseeker great again. Gonna scout it out. MLE as well. Looking at the Roshan. Well, actually, he's placed a ward here. But, Aggro Roshan. Kingy on the ghost swap. Back it off. Stevie looking for some art.
Tis mine.
As far as farm is concerned, Alex and the
Dyer's bottom tower.
He threw the glimpse in and they want to help him out actually. Damned. He gets killed and casually goes back to farming agents. Lambda card position once again really costs team gold and experience here. 640 XP weight on the mage for that mistake.
Dyer's bottom tower is under attack.
I see. My grand
spirit. Bloodseeker great again. Gonna go down. No. There's no way he gets out. No. He tries to cut Blanishron, but the
you feed the crabs. Triple threat.
Stevie Blanishron and Big Daddy Blob's FS crazy match. Stevie gonna be aware that Kingy's here. He aura from his soul, from his invades from Ghostwalk, given up his position. Doesn't seem too bothered by it. Morbid Mask picked up now on Steve, so I would expect to see Dominator on her. Hit. Oh, and Pull Dust. Double Smoke even picked up for Puck. Sean trying to get his team under control here, trying to get something at coordinator. Bit of a gush forward onto Anton. Oh, Kingy is in the back here. There's a Sentry Ward which will catch a
Dyer's bottom tower is under attack.
And then he scouts out the invisibility rune, and the invisibility rune is fun for Kingy to pick up here. He's going to get scouted, he's definitely visible from that ward. There are the shells, and Kingy getting caught by their position. There's the swallow from MFC. Kingy going to get out to safe. Ghostwalk still up. MFC going to go down. Sacrificial Lamb, the savior of Kingy. And going to be quite pleased with
Dyer's bottom tower is under attack.
Let's look at the farm though. 10,750 on Animage. 10,788.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Illusion!
And 5,838 on Invoker. 5,722 on Timbersaw. All farm being on the PA on the Animage. These are the guys, the big kills. Another kill goes away on Stevie. Stevie gonna get the ghost walk. Antonio Lamal with the chains and catches him with the whirling death. The pure damage too much. 580 gold for the task. Gonna be so happy. That's a huge deal for them. Gonna give only minus 26 gold though, but still checks me. MFC caught out again in a bad position. Gonna actually go down, I think, Pass Castle here, with the,
that one admired my wings, but could not be trusted to care for her own.
Pop the Dream Call for her, the position 5.
Dyer's top tower is under attack.
They're gonna be too concerned about that trade. They got the PA off, so, I guess. Meanwhile, Amal trying to push. Timbersaw, great at clearing waves, rubbish at pushing towers.
Dyer's top tower is under attack.
Where did he go to? It's Mick. Where did he? What? So five of their of Belgium.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Casually pushing the bottom
Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
I mean, all they need to do is space farm, space farm, space farm, and eventually the anti-mage will be too strong in their lineup to deal with. He just needs to get a BKB, an MKB, and a heart, and space it.
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's top tower has fallen.
I see there the Ravage, but there is no follow-up yet. The Ravage
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Be TP'd in, but it's going to Dire's be
structures
to be
are fortified.
Lambda out of position. Banner King is in, eats half of a
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
And then immediately has to back, unfortunately. RE ring, static ring, just for no reason. Well played, very good use of your skills, time, energy. So the mana style almost completed for Alex here. F Alex.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Just casually farming the jungle. There's the mana style on these lads. So his farming should now be up far in excess of.
Dire's top tower is under attack. Dire's top tower has fallen.
Push top tower there. There are three heroes for the Dire in the jungle here. This ward can scout them all out. Plus, he could get ready for Blob's FS. He doesn't have his ult. I'm not sure if he knows that. I'm not sure why he's backing.
Tis mine.
Definitely get something done here.
Dire's top tower is under attack. Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Cold snap on Lambda. He's going to get absolutely blown up by the army mage. With the exploding head trick, and he also hits
up
on the back out. This anti-mage white.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
The ultimate catching is at the worst possible time. There's no caution being shown by the disruptor. Quite happy to be.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
The death of his teammates.
Dire's top tower has fallen.
Another one bites dust, and that's it now. 15-15.
Mega kill, unstoppable double kill.
Okay, double kill.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
He's just going to pop forward and right-click them down. No problems here at all. This is going to be definitely racks here. They only have three heroes up. PA going to try something on Tony Lamal, probably the
Radiant's
worst person to attack there, unfortunately. The blink in, the dream coil on three though, followed up by the Ravage. Is it going to be enough to finish anyone? Are they going to be able to get anyone down? The anti-mage super low, and Stevie though going to go down, do the damage. No, he's going to blink out. Antonio Lamai trying to find him with the chakra, and just not going to find it. The chains.
Tower is under attack.
Here's this ice shard. It's going to drop him, but Stevie's slowly healing up here. Chakra tornado. Tornado's going to be too much. Into the sunstrike. What is he doing? The sunstrike. Stevie, amazing. Managing to stay
Radiant's bottom
on
tower
his
is under
feet.
Attack. Dire's top barracks has fallen.
Skull Basher finished up now as well. This could help out. Blink forward, blink strike forward, but no, I'm gonna get caught out.
Dire's
double stun on the UP. Stevie goes down. Bladetron gonna be next on the list. There's nothing to stop these guys now. The rocks will definitely fall. And rotate to bottom, guys. Uh, 2816 XP, 1211 gold swing, and that's not even all the fight. They're just gonna go mid. Whirling blades. Whirling death. Chakra. Even chakra. Chakram.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
So Make Bloodseeker great again. Gonna get the honor of taking the last hit here. That's gonna be some gold in his pocket.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
Ag's Scepter picked up for Invoker. Gonna be seeing a lot more combos coming out of Kingy now. Alex with 5k net worth advantage at the moment. BKB finished up, sitting on 1000 gold. I mean, does he go for crits maybe? Turn him out. Gonna get some reactive armor charges up so he can tank this Roshan. MFC gonna add the minus armor that they need. Here comes the lifesteal on the anti-mage. And Bob's FS crazy, none the wiser. If he had a blink,
Roshan has fallen to the radiant.
Gonna get blinked on instead by anti-mage. Immediately, he's gonna pick up the. The shards just reaching long enough. There
Tide rat! Got to keep moving or I suffocate.
But he walked back into four heroes. Jump forward from the on image, immediately blows up the Shadow Shade with no problems there at all. BKB is up for the on image. There will be quick out. He's taken a beating.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
So badly to deal with EA so effectively. Will find the kill on Lambda though. Lambda though with the Thunderstrike.
Dire's middle tower.
The storm touches my coil again.
Tusk gonna go down. Timperson, a lot of trouble. The Ravage, the Blink, the Dagger, the Chakra.
Dire's middle barracks are under attack.
Killing must
Unimage to the rescue. Somehow, Timperson stays alive throughout. And Shatter Shaman going to try and Unimage by himself. The shackles are there. There is a buyback from PAPS Dagger. She TP'd and then Blink back in. The Aegis is expelled. Shadow Shaman just gonna get blown up here. Pop your mana.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Buyback from Anti-Mage. Here he comes. He TP's in. He's decided to go for the objectives. He's gonna get attacked again by the PA. His mana style is down. And is Anti-Mage gonna die back?
Taken before my time.
Manages to survive, heal up from
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Pop.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
I'm not sure what Anti-Mage is doing here. I mean, the top tower is gone, middle tower is gone. Bottom is the only objective left. I think he wants to try and get the creep wave in onto
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
The tier 4 towers, but
Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
World.
Puck buyback then.
Dire's bottom barracks are under
defense.
Attack.
What?
Oh, the meatball onto PA. That magic damage I was talking about so much at the start. And the MKB still not showing up yet. The swap back in and PA will get caught with the pure damage of the Whirling Death.
Dire's middle tower
only
is under
Puck
attack.
Left up. There was a buyback on Puck. They will call the GG.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
Oh no. Wait, what?
Thank you.
Dire's structures are fortified.
Anti-Mage gonna go ahead and kill
Thou art purified.
The Dire trapped in their fountain while
Dire's ancient is under attack.
Merry on their ancient.
Radiant victory.
So, Fettyattack 786, take the series 2-0. I mean, as expected, Bell Gaming, I mean, Stevie did a much better job that time. The Disruptor Lambda just fed. I don't know if he was intentionally feeding or what. Looking at his net worth at the end there, he certainly ended up as a position 5 despite all those kills. Shadow Shaman only with one kill and still somehow out farming him with his net worth there, and he even has a blink dagger. So yeah, I mean, good luck next year guys, and we'll see you in future tournaments and whatnot.